Welcome, and thank you for downloading this week, Take Aim Outdoors, the Bow Hunters Podcast. Whitetail hunting stories, tips, and gears from across country. And now, here is your host, Brandon Hammonds.
All right. Hey, everybody. We're back. Brand new episode of Take Aim. And as always, this episode is brought to you by my good friends at the Enforcer Ozone Portable Ozone Unit. Rechargeable, lasts 2 to 4 hours, charges your cell phone. It is the most portable ozone unit on earth. Literally from your closet to a backpack, you can take this thing anywhere, to your vehicle, a locker room, at the gym. You can do anything with this ozone, so make sure you check out the Enforcer Ozone product line. Today's show, sadly, I was supposed to be with Anthony Dixon, and Anthony has bailed on us. I don't know where Anthony is, so I'm sure I'll catch up with Anthony this week. Big happy birthday to him. I know that he had an awesome birthday and actually got to go to opening night in Vegas for the Golden Knights. Anthony's a huge NHL fan, so I'm sure he's traveling, and we'll touch base next week and get him back on the show, which I'm excited about. But in the meantime, like always, I'm going to get another in-season report out. Got a few updates from some names you know, like Scotty Goodwin, Kerry Zilka, James Johnson. Maybe you don't know some of them, but excited to get some of these out. I'll start with Michigan, or at least South Central Michigan. We've had a couple crazy and sporadic days. We've had 70-degree days. We've had 50-degree days. And everything in between. We've had nothing really colder than about 55 as of late in the last week. But in the last week, until this rain just hit, which came in kind of Wednesday night, a lot of the farming community started to take off crops. So a lot of our soybeans, a lot of bean fields have already come out, and they're starting on the corn. With this rain, some of the moisture levels probably went back up, and some of the corn fields won't come out for a while yet, which is okay with me because it's ample cover, and it changes two or three of my farms that I hunt significantly. But last week, this past week I should say, there was a couple bruiser bucks that fell down, at least in this community of Branch County, Hillsdale County. There are some really good deer that were killed. And I would say, you know, one of the better deer was probably 165-inch 10-pointer. With some extra junk on it. So that's about what we're running with here in the South Central. James Johnson gave me a report from Sanilac County in the thumb of the Michigan. Like, so if you put the hand up and do the, you know, mitten look, right up there in the thumb is where Sanilac is. But he said the same thing. It was a little warm. He's seen some deer movement, still seeing younger bucks, and a lot of the older bucks, from what he said, are still strictly moving at night. Paul Pierce from Eastern Kentucky, sadly they got hit with some EHD, but he just basically sent me a small little message, said white oak still, or they are still in the white oaks. It needs to cool down a little bit for some better deer movement, and he just said it's been very warm and slow there. Dirk Thibodeau from Louisiana sent me a message, said, hot here in the south, but white oak starting to drop, so get after them Tuesday. That was a couple days ago. So if you're in the south, it sounds like a lot of the white oaks are starting to hit the ground. So this time of year, it is such a preferred food source. I know the southern boys know it really well. A lot of us don't follow the acorn theme as much. We're so used to the big crops, but if you have acorns and can get on some white oaks, man, it is a magnet. It is preferred food source this time of year, no doubt about it. As you guys know, my good pal Scotty Goodwin, he's seen a couple decent bucks this past week, but same thing. It's hot in he's in western Indiana, and it's been hot on his area of that northwestern part of the state. He did see a couple of shooters this past week. When I say shooters, I'm talking 120 and above. Not a deer he really wanted to kill on this farm because he has potential for some really big bucks on this farm. So nothing Scotty wanted to take a shot at, but he's got out and hunted. He said the same thing. White oaks are starting to fall, and some of the local farmers in that area are starting to get some of the crops out. So if you're in that part of the state, you know, pay attention. A lot of those deer, you know, like always, if those crops are coming down, deer have to find new hiding spots. So make sure you're in those areas that you can access fairly easy and snug close to those bedding areas, because those deer have to get back to some deeper cover. Trying to double check some of my messages as I'm doing this live, or in real time, I should say. My buddy James Zier was headed from, he lives in Fort Wayne, Indiana, was headed to what would be southeastern Illinois to hunt a farm that he owns there. And sadly, does not look like James gave me any feedback yet. So I don't know what he saw over the weekend. I was hoping he left me a message, but I don't see it. But I'll touch base with James. He's got a phenomenal piece and some absolute mega bucks come out of there. Paul Schmidt from Ohio, South Central Ohio, says acorns are starting to drop. A lot of the deer have been in the timber morning and evening. So basically the same thing. Acorns. What it sounds like. So make sure if you're hunting those areas like that, pick your best spots morning and evening based on those thermals and get close to those oak trees. So another thing I was going to try to do is incorporate in the in-season report this year is some of the peak moon times, and I'm going to basically just cover the weekends for everybody, and we'll try to do this every week from now until you know, December. But as of, we're going to go start with Friday. Peak time on an AM hunt today was 8:02 AM, and the peak time tonight is 8:28. So depending on where you live, it's dark here at 8:28 PM. So that peak time is going to be in the dark basically for us. So Saturday we have 8:57 AM peak moon phase of the day, 9:22. So the evening hunt does not play for us because it's in the dark once again. On Sunday, we have 9:49 a.m. and 10:14 p.m. So once again, the evening hunt won't matter. But if you guys can hold out every morning and sit till at least 10, you're going to run through those peak morning times, morning lunar times. And hopefully, I don't know if you guys are into that stuff or not. I'm just trying to, you know, kind of take some data on it and make my own decisions on it. I see so much crap on Facebook about the lunar times. Some believe in it, some don't. Who knows if, you know, it's just another thing where they're selling us snake oil, so to speak. But I just thought it'd be cool to kind of let everybody know those times, and you know, send me feedback on those times. Let me know what you do see or what you don't see, and we can make our own decisions that way. So basically, that's all I got for this weekend. Coming up anyways, but weather wise you know, it's gonna be so. We got a 50 degree morning for the weekend pretty much every day. Nothing too exciting. There's no drastic changes to look forward to this weekend, so it's just gonna be one of those weekends where you just kind of got to get out there and hunt. I'm excited. I'm actually having my son come out to deer camp this weekend, and I got a double bolt blind up this morning, myself and Scott Hunter. We got her brushed in, and hopefully tomorrow Maddox will hopefully put an arrow in one right off the bat. It'd be a great start to the weekend. I'm really excited about that, and just hanging out and having some father-son time should be awesome. We'll give you guys an update. We'll let you know what happens next week's show, but we'll continue with the in-season report. I think I kind of got a lack of feedback just based on the weather. It's been really kind of just so hot here the past 10 days that it does not feel like hunting season. So I would assume next week I'm going to have a lot more to report for you guys. So make sure to check that out. As always, check us out on podbros.com, the Outdoor Podcast channel. Both are on iTunes. Check out the websites as well. And make sure you check out the Enforcer Ozone. And we'll see you guys next week.